Booyah, Pad Crasher. Hey everybody, Mike from Fisher MN here. From that little intro, you can see today we're going to be talking about frogs. My favorite way to fish bass. If you followed my channel from its beginning, for the first probably 3.5 years, this is all I used was a frog. Early in the morning, midday, late, this is what I had on. I wasn't very diversified in my fishing, and I'll tell you why. There's nothing more exciting than getting that topwater strike on a frog. Now, that being said, there's a few things you can think about when you're using a frog. First is our equipment. We'll get back to the frog in a minute. The equipment that I use is a medium heavy rod. I've got a St. Croix Legend Extreme saltwater blank that I use. This is my ultimate frog rod. But I would say in Minnesota, that's where I'm based out of, any medium heavy rod. Some people like to go heavy. I've never had a problem with medium heavy with the bass that I'm catching. And then you want to have a nice bait casting reel with some heavy line. I tend towards Daiwa. This is a Daiwa Tatula, and I like a higher gear ratio. The gear ratio means how much your line you're taking in with every crank. And when you're fishing in heavy cover, you want to be able to get those bass up and out of that cover fast. This one is an 8.1 gear ratio. They go all the way up to 10, but 8.1 has always served me well. Nice medium heavy rod, nice bait caster, and then got to use some heavy line if you're going to be cranking them out of that heavy cover. And I've got 60 pound Super Slick version 2 on this reel. So this will get it done. Now, not everybody can have a buddy like I do and build their own custom rod. So if I'm buying a rod, I'm gonna be buying a St. Croix. I love St. Croix rods. Their Bass X line is pretty affordable. I know $100 for a rod is a lot for a lot of people, but you get a good quality rod and it's gonna last you forever. And if you do have a problem, say you set that hook and it snaps in half, you know what, St. Croix will send you a new one out. So that's kind of the nicer thing about the higher end rods. You can get a replacement rod if you have a problem. These Bass X rods, I think they're up to 119 now, but Bass Pro always has a rod trade-in. And I think as fishermen, we all have rods sitting there in the garage that we don't use. You can trade in a rod and get some dollars off a new rod, which is what I did this year for another setup that I'm using. So medium heavy rod, good bait casting reel. I would say Lewes might be a good choice for you to get a combo, a bait casting rod and reel. And sometimes you can be in the $100 to $150 range for everything on that, because the reels can get pretty expensive also. But first tip, have a nice rod and reel to use when you're frog fishing. Because the main thing with frog fishing is setting that hook, and you need a good combo to do that. So once you're all set up, you need the lure. And I tell you, the Booyah Pad Crasher, I'm not sponsored by Booyah Bait Company or anything. I just love them. They have the perfect mix of great hooks, nice sharp hooks, and a soft body, but not too soft. And I like the colors that they have. This one has a white belly and a green back. And what I do, first little tip here, is I use it exactly like this. I'm not one, I hear people bending the hooks out and all that kind of stuff. I've never had to do that. If you have a good rod and reel and you have a good aggressive fish, you're gonna be able to get that hook set into them all the time. The only thing I do, I don't know if it helps or not, is I trim the legs. So I make one leg shorter than the other. See how that's just a little shorter there? I've always done that. I don't want the legs to be hanging as far down as they do. In Minnesota, we have a lot of northerns and they tend to target the legs. So sometimes you'll get those legs pulled off if you don't do that. Plus it just kind of casts a little better. There we go. Shows a little bit of an injury there maybe to the frog, something that bass might be looking for. But that's how I use my Booyah Pad Crasher. Probably 95% of my bass in the summer will be caught on a Booyah Pad Crasher. I have my frog box. This is where I store my supply for the year. But this year I'm more specialized in my kayak, so I have a box dedicated to frogs. So we'll get this one back in the box. And most of them are Booyah Pad Crashers. I always, for whatever reason, have liked the Spro black and yellow frog. So sometimes on those very cloudy days when other things aren't working, I'll put on a Spro. Once again, good hooks. Trim that leg a little bit shorter on one side. And I have to, in this box, keep some of the original frogs that got me into frog fishing. And these are the Reaction Innovation Swamp Donkeys. I got these from Tackle Warehouse. They're not super easy to find. For those of you who like to bend your hooks up, you can kind of see the hooks are different. They're actually bent up a little bit. These have great hook set ratios. I would probably have a box full of these, but one, the colors aren't exactly what I like. And two, they're more expensive. The Booyah Pad Crashers, if you get them on a sale at Bass Pro in the spring, you get them for about $5 a piece. And these generally run about $10 a piece. And like I said, in Minnesota, we got a lot of northern, so you're gonna lose a frog or two here and there. Got a couple of other random frogs in here, but for the most part, Booyah Pad Crasher all summer. I bet I caught over 1,000 bass on Booyah Pad Crashers. One last little pro tip, if you will, is mend it. I keep a little bottle of this whenever I'm frog fishing, and this is just liquid plastic. And if you have a little cut on your frog, you just dab this on and it dries within 2 minutes and you're good to go with your frog again. So this can save a frog or two, or at least let you use it a few more times if you get a slice in it from a northern or something else happens to it. So, great way to store our frogs. Got plenty of them in the boat all summer long. Generally, I'm fishing frogs early as the sun's coming up. But if you've ever seen some of my videos from Favorite Lake in Grand Rapids, that frog bite can go all day. There's nothing better. Something I hear almost every tournament for the Bassmasters Elite Series, if you ever watch that on TV, those pros get so excited when they get bites on frogs. I think if they could, they'd fish them all the time. But when you have to fish all day, you have to go to some other tactics. So let me know in the comments, what kind of frogs do you use? And if you had a choice, is that the lure that you would pick to catch that monster bass on? I'm guessing most people would say yes. Stay tuned. Next week, we're going to go over another one of my favorite lures, the chatterbait. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Thank you.